Hello, 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 and welcome to the 22nd video of this summer vacation slash coronacation slash coronavirus slash epidemic here. And the focus movie of the week is the movie called Mr. Peabody and Sherman. Great movie for the family. And if you guys just want to watch, it's actually a really funny movie. As you can see, these two are the main characters, and they travel through time. I don't want to spoil anything, but one of them is really smart, and one of them is just there to have fun. Figure out which one is the smart one, and which one's just the one tagging along. But it's a great movie. Highly recommended. I watched it when it came out, because I was a bit young. I was around your ages when it probably came out, probably not, but I saw the movie. It was great, amazing, loved it. So let's get going. So multiplication, I've been talking about multiplication for quite some time now. It's been, the third video out of 22 videos where I'm using multiplication, maybe four, maybe more, depending on if you want to count the area one, doesn't matter. Point is that multiplication has been heavily focused in this video lessons, and it's basically just because addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division are the four biggest things you need to know. So once we're done with multiplication, I'm going straight into division, and we're going to spend a lot of time on that. As of now, there are a lot of videos left of multiplication. And I'm just looking at my lesson plans and stuff. Like, I probably will be doing another 5 to 6 videos on just multiplication, and then we finally go into division. These two topics you guys need to know. You need to understand, and you need to know. This is why I will spend so much time on this, because it's that heavily forced, and I won't slam a lot of things. As you saw in the multiplication tables videos, I split it apart. I'm not going to give a crap ton of concepts in this short video and then say, here you go, and then have another video a week later and just keep, and then, sorry about that, and then do the same exact thing. No, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to do very slowly. These are going to be light concepts that are not that hard, and we're just going to build up. We're going to go little step by step, little steps to the big goal. And once you understand multiplication, you understand how to do it, you'll be well on your way, and then we'll talk about division, and then we'll move on. So without further ado, so there are kind of what people like to call properties in multiplication, which can be sort of like rules. There are three of them. The commutative, which is the most simplest one, easiest one to understand. The next video will be associative. And the next one will be, after that, distributive property. So these three, commutative, associative, distributive. So this one, the first video, the 23rd video, number 23, will be on this, and the 24th will be on that. So just by looking at that, the next three videos, or the next two videos, are already set up. And there's still so much more that we need to talk about. So it will be a lot of more videos on just multiplication. So I'm not gonna, I know I was jumping a lot on topics, but from now on, I'm really just gonna stick to a big topic and then just do little subtopics. Like, I'm going multiplication, then I went into multiplication tables, commutative properties, or properties in general. Like, I did multiplication, properties, and then I went into properties with these three. So I think I'm gonna focus on that more. And as I said before, I'm not a pro at this. This is my first time doing it, so bear with me. I'm learning here as you are learning on these videos. So, properties. They're basically rules to help you understand certain things. Three of them are unique, not hard to understand or grasp, but it's relatively important that you understand these rules because you could see something on test. If you don't know these rules, it'll be you'll make your life much, much harder than it needs to be. But if you do know these rules, your life will be very easy and simple. So the commutative, what does it mean? Well, basically, as I said before, it's a property, and a property is a rule. So basically, the commutative property is a math rule that says that the order in which we multiply numbers does not change the product. So, I don't know if you heard this before, but multiplication and addition are the same thing as division and subtraction. They go hand in hand. These two things go hand in hand, and division and subtraction go hand in hand. So, if I added numbers 4 plus 5, we would get 9. If I did 5 plus 4, we would also get 9. So for multiplication and addition, the commutative property, it's the same exact thing. It doesn't matter about the order of the numbers. You could say 4 plus 5 or 5 plus 4, it doesn't matter. You're gonna get the same answer. It does not change the answer or what we call the product. But in subtraction, let's say if I did 4 minus 3, we would get 1. But if I did 3 minus 4, would it be 1? No, it would not. It would be a totally different number. 3 minus 4 is not the same as 4 minus 3. Obviously, we would get a number that's below 0. We would get a number that's below 0. So these two numbers are not the same. So the commutative property only goes for multiplication and addition because those two things are related. Like, remember when I said 2 times 3 could also be written as 2 plus 2 plus 2? Like, multiplication and addition, they go like that. They're like twin brothers. They're the same exact thing. Just one is preferred over the other in certain scenarios. That's it. Multiplication, addition are like that. Division and subtraction are like the cousins, twin cousins of the twin brothers. So the commutative property, all you need to understand is that you can write it however way you want and you'll still get the same answer. So let's use an array for practice. I remember I was doing, pretty sure I was doing columns times rows in previous videos, but the traditional way you use an array is you do rows times columns. Oh, my M is not that good. Rows times columns. Whoop, the N, then S. Tricky word. So it's rows times columns. So it's vertical times horizontal. So let's count it. How many rows do we have? Okay, how many columns? Perfect. Rows times columns. 3 times 6. Now I just want you to count. Count the red dots. How many red dots do we have? Okay, 18. So just take that number. Remember that 18. We said 3 times 6 is 18, right? We're using rows times columns, right? So what happens if I did this and I turned it around like that? Just did like a 90 degree turn. Count the rows, count the columns. We got 6 rows and 3 columns. So the rows number changed. We changed the rows number from 3 to 6, and the columns number changed from 6 to 3. However, if we do rows times columns, 6 times 3, rows times columns, rows times columns, count the number of red dots we have. We have 18. So no matter which way we write this equation, if we put 3 first or 3 second, it doesn't matter. We're gonna get the same exact answer, and that is what this property is. The commutative property basically says we can do whatever order we want with the numbers. The order could be 3 times 6 or 6 times 3. It doesn't matter. We will always land with the same answer. And as I was saying before, we saw that with addition as well, because multiplication and addition are like twin brothers. However, division and subtraction, it does not work. Just to keep that in mind, that idea in mind for in the future, I guess, when we do talk about division as well. But I want to show you this. This is like another way of looking at it. Same exact thing. 3 times 5. So they're doing it in this scenario. I just picked this picture up. They're doing columns times rows. Oops, again I spelled it wrong. Columns times rows. That's what they're doing in this scenario. They said, okay, we have 5 columns. No, we have 5 rows and 3 columns. We have 3 rows here and 5 columns. So if we said 3 times 5, or if we did 5 times 3, we still have 15 dots. Still the same thing. We're still going to get 15 dots. Like going back to this thing over here, no matter which way I turn this around, if I made it huge and turned it around, or if I made it super small and turned it around, it doesn't matter. Because we're always going to have 18 red dots at the end of the day. So the commutative property basically says no matter which order we have, if we go 3 times 4 times 9 times 10 times 11, it doesn't matter. We're still going to get the same answer as if I said 9 times 4 times 10 times 11 times 3. Or in a simpler sense, if I just said 4 times 9, we're going to get the same answer as 9 times 4. We're going to get the same exact answer. So basically, I hope you understood it, the concept. If you need a little refresher, if you're just not really understanding or it's really not clicking, shoot me an email. Of course, we're going to continue on the road of multiplication. And just restating what I said before, commutative property, you can change the order of how the numbers are. One number could be first or it could be second. It doesn't matter. You will always get the same answer. Always. Okay. Alright, guys. Hope you enjoyed this little video here. Stay safe. Stay cool. And stay learning. Bye-bye.